we've discovered a spontaneous mutation that causes color blindness. What I mean by spontaneous is that these individuals were born with a mutation in an enzyme called phosphodiesterase 60 that causes them to have color blindness. And so that means that their world is in shades of gray, and it's difficult for them to see in bright light conditions like a sunny day. In people, this affects about 1 in 10,000 individuals, and it has profound consequences on their life.
It all really began and could not have happened without the observations of astute veterinarians and veterinary technicians at the California National Primate Research Center, who had made individual observations in various living quarters, in various corrals, of individual primates that had been exhibiting behaviors of vision impairment.
So the behaviors that the macaques are showing are what's called saluting. So they'll actually shade their eyes, and that makes sense because their normal environment is like looking into really bright sunlight. And so by shading their eyes, then they can see more easily. Also, individuals were described to be holding, for example, an impaired primate would be holding the hand of a normal primate to help guide them around. That we see that more commonly when they're in new environments.
We have what amounts to a large examination room that has everything that you could expect from a top flight eye center there for the non-human primates. And it's set up in a very organized way that makes it where we can examine all elements of the eye, beginning with the front all the way to the back, from the moment that an animal has been sedated and made comfortable to perform these tests.
While we knew that there was some sort of macular disorder in these animals, we didn't know how profoundly affected they were, how their retina was functioning, that actually their cone receptors weren't functioning at all. And so when we got that electroretinogram, that first one where the cones were a complete flat line, that was a very exciting day. In fact, our technician thought that the machine was broken, and we're like, no, this is very exciting. This is a big discovery.
So that's when we really suspected that they could be related and that the source of their vision impairment could be hereditary. We sent samples of their DNA to our collaborating team at Baylor College of Medicine, and that team has a long and deep history of genetic testing for retinal diseases, and they were able to very quickly help us. We gave them a list of genes, of over 40 genes that are known to cause cone cell disorders. And we said, please sequence the DNA of these animals. Please look first at these 40 or so genes that are known to cause this type of disease. And within a couple of weeks, they gave us an answer, and they were able to pinpoint the exact mutation that was causing the problem that was common between all of these animals. We asked our colleagues at the University of Iowa, who are experts in the study of the exact gene that was mutated, we asked them to determine what this mutation was doing to this gene and how it was making it defective. And they were able to study that and determine it using protein biochemistry and sort of looking at this specific mutation in this specific phosphodiesterase gene that is required for the conversion of light specifically in cone cells.
And if we can cure this mutation with either gene or cell-based therapy or both, we think that we would be able to use similar techniques to help people with the more common forms of cone dystrophy. There's currently no treatment for this condition, and one of the exciting possibilities about our research is by being able to cure it in rhesus macaques or non-human primates, that we would be able to then translate that discovery to people.